Only begotten Son, Jesus Christ,
into our flesh.
You laid on him our sin, giving him into death so that we might not die eternally. And because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns to all eternity, in the saving faith he given to us, all who believe in him will overcome sin and death and will rise again to new life. Therefore, the angels and archangels and all company of heaven, we too would laud to magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, truly blessed are you, Lord God, our God, King of all creation. For you've had mercy on us, given your own begotten Son to believe in him. We won't perish, but we'll have eternal life. So we give you thanks for that redemption you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Grant your Holy Spirit that we may faithfully eat and drink the fruits of his cross and receive the blessings of forgiveness, life, and salvation that comes to us in his body and blood. Hear us, Lord, as you have taught your disciples to come before you in prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do remember to me. The same man also took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink of it, all of you. This cup is a new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you. Forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it. You do remember to me, and the peace of the Lord be with you now and always. Thank you. You may be seated as we turn to our response this morning. Number 570, just as I am, without one plea. 1256. We join together in our prayer of thanksgiving. We thank and praise you, Lord, for all the blessings and the gifts of your salvation, your love, your goodness, and the way you watch over us and feed and nurse us in the saving faith. Thank you, Lord, that we can turn to your cross and know that we have been washed by your blood, that we have been filled with that celebration of life, love, your righteousness, your declaring us justified and holy in your name. Thank you, Lord, for blessing richly in goodness and grace and filling us with that celebration of life and love that you alone can give. O God, the Father and source of all fountain and goodness, who in your love and kindness you sent your only begotten Son into our flesh, we thank you that for his sake you have given us pardon and peace in the sacrament. And we ask that you would never forsake us, but to rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may be enabled constantly to serve you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We turn to our bulletin, again, the Reformation benediction. Among all gifts, the gifts of the Word of God is the most valuable. The Word which proclaims that God is merciful and promises the forgiveness of sins and life everlasting. Let the Word of God be ever in your heart and on your lips and in your ears. New understanding, pleasures and devotions, and purifies the hearts and thoughts. When people can cling to the Word of God in this way, our Lord and the entire heavenly kingdom, the hosts, smile. Number 525, crown him with many crowns. Thank you. Amen. What a wondrous and glorious God that we know and we have each and every day. Any announcements this morning? Yeah, Brenda, first.
If you all haven't forgotten, today is the day of our voters' assembly meeting following coffee in the fellowship hall. Like to see as many as possible. Thank you.
Okay. Now. Now, I know, Lon, that one of you has a birthday.
It's Cheryl Ann.
Okay. So that's a special occasion today. She brought cake and celebrate that. So we give the Lord thanks for those special occasions. Only that in that life that he put together each day. In that new life that we see that he knit together. Any other announcements this morning?
This day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
In his righteousness, his holiness, in his grace and great love we go forth. Amen.